Nancy Kohler. I am chief of the Apex Predators Program of NOAA Fisheries. And the group that I work with studies basic life history of apex predators, sharks, skates, rays, tuna, billfish. We deal more specifically with the sharks. And this group has the longest running shark tagging program in the world, started back in 1962. They're called apex predators, and that means that they're at the top of the food chain. So they're very important in a particular ecosystem or a particular area, and we need to keep those fish and their populations healthy for many reasons. For sustainability, for people being able to catch fish, for recreational and commercial fisheries, and to have those sharks around forever. Our program studies basic life history of sharks, and that involves aspects of food habits, reproduction, age and growth, and the migrations and the abundance. All of this information is important to study about the sharks because it leads into assessments. We want to know how old the sharks are, how fast they grow, what do they eat, where do they live, what kind of habitat do they live in, and longevity, stock identity. All of this basic information will lead into how many fish people can catch, how many sharks they can catch. Sharks live are long-lived species. Some of them live 60, 70 years. So in order to get the full information about their reproductive habits and migratory routes, we do long-term monitoring. And this includes the shark tagging program as well as fishery independent surveys and fishery dependent surveys, meaning that we go out on a research boat or charter vessel and fish for the sharks. And while we're on the boat, we tag and release many of the fish and we gather biological information. They're highly migratory. They use large bodies of water for their life cycles. And we need to have these long-term programs in order to detect any changes in abundance, changes in food habits, things that affect them, but also affect other parts of the ecosystem. And for me, it's exciting to be able to put this information into context that can be used to help the species and to help sustainable management, you know, people to be able to, recreational fishermen to catch them, commercial fishermen to be able to catch them and provide food, and just to understand the complex life history of so many different kinds of sharks and how different they are and how they deal differently with the environment. I mean, to me, that's the most exciting part. In the shark tagging program in the Northeast, it just brings awareness to people that there are sharks out there and they do really cool things.